Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 brought a lot of different changes and some new features and hundreds of sort of refinements, but nothing really revolutionary. We got SharePlay, which I think a lot of people appreciate, but nothing that was a huge redesign or anything like that. And so I wanted to share five features that I think Apple should change. In fact, in my experience, just whether that be in a regular workplace or in day-to-day life, it's never a good idea just to complain about a feature, but rather offer a solution of something they could change. So I wanted to share that with you. Now, the first thing I think they should change is the control center. This is something that a lot of people thought should be updated or was going to be updated in iOS 15, and it never showed up. Some people had said they'd seen a remade control center, and I think that makes a lot of sense in two different ways. One of them, just the overall design, I really miss where you used to pull up from the bottom and you'd have it just showing part of the overall control center. And another way is it's hard to access from the upper right if you have, say, a phone with a notch in it. Typically, you have to use two fingers or two hands with an iPhone 13 Pro Max or some of the larger phones. You can sort of reach up there like that if you have large enough hands, but it's still not as convenient as, say, a phone with Touch ID, where you can just slide up from the bottom when you want to use it. I'd like to see a gesture come back where we could do that, either a gesture or a button, and I think that makes a lot of sense. A redesigned control center, I don't think it really matches the overall aesthetic of the entire OS. And I think we should see that along with better quick turnoffs and things for Wi-Fi and Bluetooth toggles. And that's the next thing. A lot of people would like to see Wi-Fi and Bluetooth sort of be able to turn on and off completely, not just sort of go to sleep and disconnect until tomorrow, but actually turn off Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Maybe by long pressing, we could have an off button. A lot of people would really like to see that where it doesn't just disconnect it for the day. So it says disconnected until tomorrow. If we long press and then maybe turned it on and off, it would be nice to have it turn off fully. So I think that's the next thing Apple should change. They should bring back an option to allow us to do that if we want to, instead of having to go to settings, then go to maybe Bluetooth, and then turn it off that way completely. I think that's something they could easily fix, and I'm surprised they haven't done that already at this point. The next thing I think a lot of people would like to see changed and is easy enough, especially now that we have the 13 series phones with smaller notches, is the battery percentage. I think Apple should bring the battery percentage back. Now, this is something I've never really been a huge fan of, and I don't typically use it, but with one of these phones, you have to go into the control center to actually see the percentage of the battery. With an iPhone 8 Plus, with an older phone with the same operating system, we have the option for that percentage. We definitely have room to sort of bring this information into the upper right and left of these displays now with the smaller notch. It's definitely something they could do, and I bet some people would even upgrade up to a newer phone just to have that percentage there. There's no way to currently do it, but I think they could just shift some of this over, maybe move the time over, and maybe put the cellular over here and give us the percentage back. I know a lot of people would really appreciate that. It's super simple, but it's something I think they should change. The next thing has to do with the display. A lot of people thought we'd have an always-on display. And if you've used an Android phone, such as this Pixel 6 Pro, this is the always-on display. We've got the time, we've got the weather, and the date. And not really much else other than the percentage of the battery. So it's giving us the overall time of the day and just some relevant information, whether or not we have notifications or not. So that's something I think they should bring to the iPhones now that we have variable refresh rates on the 13 Pro series. I was surprised we didn't see that, where you would have 10 Hertz all the way up to 120 Hertz. You could save power, and it really doesn't use a whole lot of battery on different phones that have it. And I know some people say, well, you could just use Android, but I don't necessarily want to use Android. I like the way iOS works, and I would love to see that brought to some of the newer phones. Many people were surprised that it wasn't here this year, and I think it's something that Apple should add. Another thing that I hear a lot is people want the ability to turn off the music widget that shows up on the home screen when you unlock it. So you unlock it, here's the widget. Not everybody wants this on their phone, and I think it would be great to offer an option to turn this on or off. So whether you're playing the song or not, you'll see it's not playing. We're just on the lock screen. Not everybody wants that widget there. The only way to get rid of that is to swipe closed and then turn off the screen, turn it back on, and sometimes it even shows up still. So that's something I think they should update. Just give you a simple option, go into your settings, maybe under notifications, or maybe a widget section that says, do you want the display widget for music? Yes or no? Turn it on or off. I think that would be a great way to sort of have more customization with that, and it would help a lot of people out. The next thing I think makes a lot of sense for these new Pro cameras. We have some nice new features, and in the camera, we've had the same settings for a very long time. Right now, I would love to see them change this up so that we have a new way to control settings. Right now, we have some settings you can see here. We have the option for RAW on the Pro phones, and then you have this little arrow. This arrow can easily be missed, and it activates settings that come out from the right side of the screen, depending on how you're holding it. So if I tap on this, now we've got settings, but they're over here. I think they should be over here, be more intuitive, have a little settings icon, because this is something that can be easily missed. I've got people messaging me all the time saying, how do I switch to a 16:9 photo? You can make it 4:3, you can make it 16:9 or square, but you actually have to go over here, tap on this arrow, activate those settings, then they show up, then you can change the settings, and then you can scroll up and down through them. So we have all of these nice new features, but right now, the controls are a little strange, and there's no Pro controls. This is a Pro phone. I should be able to easily control manual exposure and things like that without downloading a third-party app. Yes, you can lock focus by pressing and holding and sort of lock the exposure, but you have no manual control over those things really to control that and sort of lock it where you want in the way that you want. So you have exposure, but you don't really have all of the manual features you would normally have when you're working with a camera and a Pro camera. This is called a Pro iPhone. I would expect Pro controls there. And there's some very good third-party apps that do this, so you could definitely use that, but I would love to see it brought in here with refined controls that make a little bit more sense. If we switch to video, you'll see we have ProRes on some of these, and the options are nice, but I would like more granularity and more Pro features within the camera itself. I think that's easy enough for them to add since third-party applications can do it. Why not bring it here? Now, I've already covered the amount of features I thought I was going to talk about originally, but there's a couple more I wanted to mention. One thing I'd like to see is when you go into the phone dialer and maybe you start to dial a phone number, 1-800, for example, and then maybe just 234, just pick a number. On Android, you have the option for it to start showing you numbers that are in your address book. They'll just start popping up and giving you numbers that are similar. So as you start putting in maybe an area code that you're familiar with, it will bring up numbers that should work. So if we just pick a random area code, maybe this one, maybe it would pop up some numbers that are in your contacts that have that area code. So you don't have to remember the entire thing. This is something that Android does very well. And again, I don't want to use Android. I could do that, but you have that option on Android when you go into the dialer, and it's very nice. Now, if I bring in a Pixel, you'll see as I type 1-800, it brings up different addresses that might be in my address book or in my contacts. On the iPhone, it just doesn't do that. So as you type, it doesn't show anything. It's an easy enough feature to implement, and I think they should do this unless maybe a patent's holding them back, but it's something that I hear a lot of requests for that they wish Apple would do on their phone. And of course you could use Android, but many people want the privacy and security of iPhone or just like the way it works overall. So I would love to see that brought into the iPhone. Now, also when it comes to Apple CarPlay, there's something that I think a lot of people really would like, and that's a toggle to tell it to play music or not play music. Typically, when you plug in an iPhone, maybe you're plugging in your phone to your car and immediately it will start playing music. You don't necessarily want that. You want it to just plug in, give you your CarPlay options, maybe show the maps or something else. I think this would be easy enough to customize, and there's different workarounds you can do. Of course, turn your volume down in your car and other things, but it's something that could be very easily implemented just by going into your music settings and turning that on or off, allowing it to play when you're playing CarPlay or not. They need to add this option. I hear this all the time, that why does it play music every time, or it plays a certain song every time. They need to allow more customization for that specifically with CarPlay. So that's something I would love to see brought there. Also, one hardware feature I think a lot of people would like to see brought back is Touch ID. Many people, including my brother, really prefer Touch ID over Face ID. They find it to be more convenient, faster. Typically, if you're wearing a mask, it makes a difference there. So I think it's something I would love to see implemented again. It works great. It always worked great on the 8 Plus. And of course, you could use the 8 Plus still, but then you don't get the benefits and the speed of the newer phone with the newer cameras. So it's something I would love to see brought back as an option, maybe on a higher end phone, such as an iPhone SE 3. Or something along those lines. So hopefully we'll see something like that. So those are all of the features that I think Apple should change or bring to the iPhone. And I think most of those are fairly easy enough to implement and just get working as far as settings toggles or maybe a redesign to the control center. Let me know what you think they should change most in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.